Hey crew, I've got the key, there it is, to the Lucid Air Dream Edition Performance. We are going to take it for a drive, but first let's check out how it looks on the inside and outside. This one is painted in Eureka Gold. It's a color special to the Dream Edition models, and one of only a few colors even offered on the Lucid Air. The nose is very aero-sculpted. It has a coefficient of drag for this car of 0.20, meaning it's tied with the Mercedes-Benz EQS and Tesla Model S for most aero-efficient cars on the road. Thin LED headlights here, with a daytime running light bar running across. There we go, look at that. And these vents here up top are actually there to help cool those LED headlights and kind of move some of the turbulent moving air from in here that could be trapped over the top of the car. In profile, we've got a set of 21-inch wheels here. You can choose 19-inchers, and those are actually more aero-efficient, improve your range, but the 21s are cool because, see these caps here, and this one is removed. You can take off the caps, you could look at the rotors and calipers, or you leave them on for better efficiency. In profile, you can see that two-tone of the silver roof up top with the Eureka Gold down low, the short overhangs, meaning that we're really just using that long wheelbase for in-cabin volume. The door handles stay flush mounted until you unlock the vehicle. And at the back, I really like how the roof meets the body down low. Air badge, LED tail light does this wave across the rear with Lucid imprinted in there. And the trunk is super cool because it opens up from here. And though it's not, you know, a fastback design, it does create this super wide opening for you to easily mount or load in cargo. I like the exterior. It looks like an expensive upscale car, but how about the interior? Let's check that out. Opening up and looking inside at this Santa Monica themed interior with Napa leather seating surfaces, alpaca wool, Alcantara for the headliner, and open pore wood trim. Just such a nice blend of materials. Stepping inside, looking at the legroom situation, so much room here. This is S-class levels of rear seat accommodations. The floor is kind of high, and that's especially on the Dream Edition because it has additional battery packs to give it that extra power, whereas lesser trims in this car have a deeper floor, so your knee angle wouldn't be quite as high. I'm still very comfortable back here. The headroom is great. Got a third zone of climate control, two USB-C ports down here, some additional storage. Center armrest comes down with cup holders and storage in there. And just this massive glass roof here and in the front. Seats are so comfy too. All right, let's check out the front. Soft close. Up front, we now have a dark theme for these Napa leather seats with nice perforation, stitching, piping. They're heated, they're ventilated. Power adjustments are here with your four-way lumbar on the doors. Got some that alpaca wool, the open pore wood trim, and trigger style door releases. I like that they're knurled. Attention to detail. Sliding inside. And closing up that door. We're now looking at a curved 35-inch display. It's a 5K display. The resolution is incredible. There's some audio cues when you hit the buttons to let you know your input has been received. You can reconfigure this gauge cluster somewhat. And on the left-hand side are some hotkeys that remain. I like that it has physical air vents, not trying to reinvent the wheel here like, I don't know, Porsche Taycan maybe. The open pore wood trim up on the dashboard with the Alcantara. This looks so good. The infotainment here, you can control everything from adjustments of the steering wheel to your massaging seats to your drive modes are all here. And also adjust the ambient lighting from here as well. If you don't want the infotainment to be here, you can press and hold this and it will slide up and away, giving you access to much more storage in the center console. Very clever. This is all like properly intuitive stuff, including some of the dials, which look cool. This is for your infotainment settings. And this one is for the Dream Drive system, their active safety features, some of which are online now, some of which are being worked on. The steering wheel design looks like a proper wheel with a flat bottom, and the thickness is probably just right for the hands. Feels really good too. Interesting that this big glass piece, they interrupt somewhat with these sun visors that look like they're just suction cupped on there. But it doesn't throw me off too much, actually. It feels really familiar. Got some storage in the center console, and in here that can be removed for deeper storage. And they actually, where can I show that? It was on this. Yeah, you see that bear? They're very proud of their California design heritage, even though the car is built, manufactured in Arizona. You've got that California bear hidden in like 11 different places in this cabin. This is a really nice place to spend some time. But I'd rather spend that time driving it. Let's go. All right, I would say let's fire it up, but literally the moment you get behind the wheel and put your foot on the brake, the car is on. So we're ready to roll, and we are joined by Francisco from Lucid, and he is going to explain some things about how the vehicle works, drive modes, along with making sure we're on this correct drive route. The AC has been a little eager here, so I may turn it off and turn it back on at certain points in the drive so we don't die. But for now, we're going to start out in smooth drive mode, the most comfort, casual drive mode available to us. And to go into reversed, you just lift up on there, and we have a 360 view that takes over this whole infotainment. That's cool. And you kind of drag your finger around it as well. Ooh, it makes fun noises. And then you have your traditional backup wide-angle view there. So with that, ready to go. Now, Francisco, how do I adjust the regen settings? Make sure we're going to show off both of them.
So each of the drive modes have certain regen characteristics associated with
okay.
them. So normally, smooth tends to have the strongest regen,
okay.
with swift and sprint having progressively less aggressive regenerative braking.
Got it, okay.
And then within each of the drive modes, if you press and hold the drive mode, you can select standard or high to further customize the braking characteristics within each of the drive modes.
Got it. And I just want you guys to hear that turn signal right now. It's pretty interesting. Should we go left or right?
Left.
Okay. Never heard a turn signal like that. And that's a very strong regen. I took my foot off and immediately we were coming to a stop. We got to start by talking about this powertrain because it is pretty impressive. First off, two electric motors, and the way they've designed them is so compact. They pack everything into something that weighs like 170 pounds, two of them at the front and rear of the vehicle. And those with the battery pack available to us, I think it's 118 kilowatts, yield 1,111 horsepower here in the Dream Performance Edition. The Dream Range Edition has only like 900 something horsepower, and lesser versions of Lucid Air kind of tear it down from there. Now I say 1,111 horsepower, but you don't have access to that in smooth or swift drive mode. You have to go into the sprint drive mode to unlock all of that, and I'll show you how that looks in a second. But even what you're working with in smooth and swift, 784 horsepower, whatever, that is an absurd amount of power. And granted, we are moving 5,200 pounds here in the Dream Performance Edition and Dream Range Edition, but something tells me the instant electric torque and all of that power are going to overwhelm the weight very easily. Now, while we're still in the smooth drive mode, just speaking about one, the regen feel, which is, it's so intense. Like, you can actually drive this vehicle with just the throttle, and you can't say that for every regen system out there.
what was I? I was just in the EQS, and that one, even its most aggressive regen setting, was by no means a one pedal drive car. You'd have to plan so far in advance when you were going to take your foot off the throttle. I gotta say, I'm super impressed with the ride quality of the Lucid Air, especially considering there's nothing truly innovative about what they've going on for the suspension. It's a multi-link setup with adaptive dampers and coils. We're not using an air suspension setup here. So, okay, and that way it might be, you know, less sophisticated than its competitors, and yet it just coasts so nicely over the few bumps we've gone over. I'm blown away by that. And now in Swift drive mode, there's not that heft to the throttle. Like in Smooth, you really feel like you're having to push through some weight there, but in Swift it releases that, and so I can already tell this is going to be a raucously fast vehicle. God, you love the center of gravity being so low down, all that weight being so low.
To the 73 south.
Okay. Now this stoplight is going to be a good opportunity to perhaps test out a very brief sprint. And the way you use launch control in this vehicle is just foot hard on the brake, pin the throttle, and then you go. Here we go. Okay. All right. That's insane. Oh my gosh, and it just keeps accelerating too. There's not just the immediate, oh, it's like now just hitting me what this is capable of. It's not just the immediate gut-wrenching, just initial shock of acceleration. It's the fact that it does not relent. It keeps pushing you harder and harder into the back of the seat. That's absurd. That's absurd, right?
Giggles are almost always inevitable.
I mean, this is beyond giggling. This is... That's unbelievable.
It's very much roller coaster like.
That's nuts. That is the most G-force. I mean, okay, I've driven a Bugatti Chiron, okay? That was about as hard as I felt a mid-range pull. This is right there. Right there. And the fact that it happens the second I do that.
We're gonna take the next exit.
Okay. You were entirely too calm for what I guess you've done this enough, right?
I do this all the time.
Okay. Alright, that explains it.
Yeah. And I'm smiling under this mask.
Okay. Alright, yes, that's true. We're both wearing face masks. But holy cow.
Yes.
That is absurd. It would probably take a while for that to get old. Probably. I also, back there, I don't think I did launch control right. I wasn't even thinking. I just lifted my foot off the...
I mean, that's really all you have to do.
It's yeah. Just, it's not really anything building up, right? It's just
right.
It's just going.
It's instant torque.
Yeah. Yeah. So, 2.5 seconds to 60, says independent sources. I did not bring any gear with me to verify that, but I would believe it, definitely. But... Again, I think that more impressive than the 0 to 60 getting out of a hole is the fact that at mid-range, at any time, in sprint, when you put your foot down, you are teleporting forward. You're just there. Your neck would start hurting if you did that too often. Holy cow.
When you were at the stoplight, actually, about to take off, I made sure to put my head up against the seat.
I saw that. Out of the corner of my eye, I'm like, okay, he's putting his head back. He knows what's about to happen. I'm now going to take it out of sprint for a moment, just because I want to talk about what my short drive in this vehicle has taught me about what's been accomplished with the Lucid Air, particularly this Dream Performance, given, like, the absurd performance threshold to it. But also the fact that when I wasn't punching it on the highway, what I was listening for is a lot of wind or road noise. and I wasn't getting it. They did such an incredible job of insulating this cabin, giving these seats just the right ergonomic shape. They're supportive, I'm comfortable, it's quiet, it's smooth, it's doing the luxury thing. Frankly, way better even than the direct luxury players. And that's always been the thing, right? It's like when the luxury players get involved, when they start doing EVs, we're going to be in trouble. But I don't think Lucid's going to be in trouble, because this is doing it certainly just as well as that EQS, potentially even better, and definitely better. The blend, the mix, definitely better than that Tesla Model S. We are definitely going to have to take at least one more corner aggressively to see how the chassis behaves and what I get more from the steering when I'm really cranking it. But what a polished first act, Lucid. I've moved back to sprint mode. That also firms up the dampers. The brakes, the regen takes some getting used to, but power out of the corner. Goodness. Now, it was not a perfectly smooth corner there. There were some undulations in the road. I could feel a bit of, just a tiny bit of roll, but the confidence that you had putting the power down is so beyond the vast, vast majority of ICE cars, with the weight being so down low. The transfer of the weight in the car is not something you sense. And so as a driver, you just feel the confidence to just get on the throttle earlier. The steering feel, it definitely, like, the resistance builds in sprint drive mode. Not getting a ton of feedback through the wheel. I'm hopping back to the smooth drive mode for the final portion of this brief, admittedly brief, test drive. By no way am I going to come to some firm conclusions about the Lucid Air Dream performance from such a short amount of time behind the wheel, but I'm getting a really good taste, and that taste is super satisfying. I'm overly excited about not just this car, but what Lucid is going to do in the future, how this car is going to transform future models that might come out of it, because, again, as a first attempt, this is so impressive. The smoothness of the car, the luxury stuff, obviously the straight line acceleration, the range, which I haven't even talked about yet, probably a good time to talk about that. The Lucid Air Dream range model has an EPA estimated 520 miles. That doesn't beat, that embarrasses all of its competitors. Then this Dream Performance model, you take a bit of a hit. If you get the 19-inch wheels, I think it's like 471 miles. On these 21-inch wheels, 451 miles. That is still at the top of its segment with 1,111 horsepower. Just trying to wrap my mind around that. For them to in-house develop, design, produce an electric motor pairing and battery system and dual-stage charging, onboard charger, is like, it's nothing but impressive that this is their first attempt at this. Granted, pulling in talent from all sorts of different automakers, it's a huge feat. It is a massive, massive feat. My knocks, if I'm going to give it anything, are, I think that the dynamics, right? Like, in a corner, once again, it's confident, but the feedback for the driver isn't quite there yet. That's something they can improve upon. Just as I've been looking around, visibility isn't the best. That could be something that's improved. However, when you turn on the signal, you do get a little blind spot monitor there, and that was the first time I noticed that. That's a great benefit, because the straight-up visibility over there with that big pillar in the C pillar is not fantastic. And then, the fact that it's very expensive. It is very expensive. But it's not overly expensive. It's expensive in a segment of pricey cars. This is $169,000, I think, the one I'm testing here. But you can get a Lucid Air for as cheap as, $78,000? So, when you stack that up against the cars it would be competing against, it's more expensive than the Tesla Model S Plaid, but it makes a lot more power. It is, the range is better than the Model S. It's a little less expensive than the Taycan Turbo S. And though that car has a lot more in terms of driving dynamics that you appreciate as a driver, the interior is nowhere near as nice, and the ride quality is just not as nice. So this has distinct appeal over its competitors at a price that the buyer looking for this car is going to feel like they're not being robbed or anywhere close to it. Be assured, I'm going to get more time in the Lucid Air product, and I'll have more in-depth reviews of that. But please like, comment, and share the video. Subscribe to the channel. Hit that bell to get notified. And I'll see you again next time.